Hey, what's up guys, it's Fish here and welcome back to episode 5 of my Oriental Empires mini campaign in the closed beta. Now this episode might not be amazing because I've just got back from a wedding. It was like a 2-day event. I'm pretty exhausted, but I want to go ahead and get a video up for you guys. That does mean that Warhammer will be pushed back till tomorrow, but that does also mean that you guys will get a fairly long Dwarven campaign part tomorrow. So if you're looking forward to that, then obviously all you have to do is wait one more day. But, you know, Oriental Empires is kind of a lot easier to record, you know, and, you know, it's pretty quick as well. So, hopefully you guys don't mind too much about that. So, last episode in our Oriental Empires campaign, we finally brought our army back from all the way over here. We you know, traveled the mountains, did several encounters, which were overall pretty good, you know. We got some free technology, some free authority, and, you know, our new faction leader has 5 commands. So, he's just going to be immense in battle. And that's what we're going to try and gear up towards, so at least by the end of this episode we have a very nice army ready to at least start the war against Bar, if not already have the like first battle in the engagement this episode. Fingers crossed I get into a battle against Bar, but I don't know if we will, just because I don't know how much longer it's going to take me to build up the rest of my army. You know, we're not really the most richest faction in the world. We just built our barracks, which kind of absorbed a lot of our money, like a lot of our money. But however, as soon as we get our sword weaponsmith done, we will be able to start recruiting much, much better sword infantry and actual trained infantry. So if you look here, it will pop up in between militia and nobles. There'll be a trained like kind of slot which will pop up, which you guys will see in like 2 turns time. And that's kind of like the next level of infantry above militia, so it'll be amazing to go ahead and just start sticking them into my commands. As well as that, we also took a city over here in the mountains. This will be again a really nice like fortress defensive position. You know, it's the only way really down into our lands, and if we fight out these guys, it's going to be so difficult to actually get to us that we can be secure in these mountains. Maybe even sticking another province like up here to help fortify the rest of our land would be good. Or even just, you know, allying with this faction and kind of having them protect my borders to the north. This is what I really like about this game as well, you know. There's actually quite an in-depth, like, strategy to it, you know. You have to make friends, you have to make enemies, and, you know, it's up to you what you do with that. So, our general's moving back, we're building our roads. You can also see our road network is pretty much somewhat done now. We're just going to finally meet up these two cities right here, and then our entire empire will be connected by road, obviously apart from this city, which we literally just built. We can also have a few more cities as well, if we, what button is it? We just have to click on this, right? Yeah, if we just click on this, you can actually see that we do have 7 authority right now. So we could even think about making another city right here, or, you know, taking some more rhinos for some extra income. Or again, just taking this copper and, you know, this jade as well, because there's double jade right here. And I think we could just about get in range if we turn the hex map back on. I think it's that one. Or is it, it's one of these buttons, there we go. We could actually, you know, maybe if we stop here, we'll be just away from all of these, and we could also get the game as well. So we will, for sure, think about taking that city up there, and we'll turn that off again. Because I think it looks a lot prettier without the hex map on. And our fields are, our empire is growing. Look at that, look at all these people. Sorry. This has been a really long intro. I just wanted to kind of get that, you know, summarized for you guys. So I think we're actually just straight up ready to end the turn. We haven't really got many troops moving. Our general is moving back from, you know, doing all these encounters. Hopefully he makes it back because he looks like an absolute monster. I can't wait to throw him into combat with our new model army when we build it, obviously. We have to wait a few more turns. Yeah, thank you, dude. You already told me that. We have to wait a few more turns till this is built. I don't really know what this number stands for because it doesn't take that amount of time. I feel like this number isn't how many turns it takes. It's like the percentage of, like, there's like a percentage building thing you need to reach, and that's just 2 of that or something, you know, 2 of 2 of something, because, you know, this bar does not look like it's halfway done, even though it says it's only gonna take 2 turns. It's kind of confusing. Again, I feel like there'll be a lot more tool tips as you go into later games and stuff like that. As the game gets closer and closer to release, there'll be a lot more tooltips. Because again, something I mentioned last episode, you know, it says I can get a market, but what does a market do? I have no idea. So yeah, we're going to 100% get this. I think as we go on, it's going to be a lot easier to make money. So we want to get this. We want to get coinage because it gives us a market. It gives us this building as well, which I think will give us more money. And it allows us to enact more edicts on assault tax, which again, I assume gets us money. So we're instantly going to pick that up. Irrigation farms as well could be a good idea to go ahead and improve our farming. You know, more terrain. Okay, so this technology allows us to do it on gentle hills and steep hills. Okay, cool. So again, so the mountain one the mountain city we have getting the gold, this is going to be needed for it. But right away, we're going to grab up this economy building because I want it. I want the money. And we suffer, you know, we get a lot of money from our economy, from our trade because of our faction. We get an extra 15%. So we want to try and abuse that as much as possible. And we'll speed up the turns as well. Because all we're really doing is waiting for our weaponsmith to build and waiting for our general to make it home. He's gonna pop past our northeast city. We will be friendly because I want to be friendly with this faction. Because again, as we were talking about before, they kind of almost defend up here for us. Let's make sure we've got everywhere building farms where we can. So yeah, let's just continue building more farms over here. And this province has to be building more farms because there's not really a lot of good opportunities for them to actually build. So we'll just let half a population do that and then they can move on to that as well. Are we also building that gold mine? We don't really have enough money to build the gold mine, if I'm honest. Yeah, we can't even afford it. It does give us, a, you know, 40 gold each turn, so that will pay for itself in, what, like 30 turns? Yeah, 30 turns it'll take. But obviously, in the long run, you know, these campaigns go on for a lot longer than that, so... And accompany everything else as well. It will definitely be good. You know, normally, I guess, in longer games, you'd be playing for a lot more than 300 turns, which is what I'm doing. General is slowly making his way home. It just takes so goddamn long. Okay, cool. So our weaponsmith is now done. If I go to the train things, yeah, there we go. We can see these bad boys. So let's just go ahead. Are they going to look different or are they exactly the same? So these guys are actually better, but these guys are cheaper. So these are 8954. 8954. So these guys are a lot better. The Noble Axemen are really good. 1014 compared to the... they have 5 more defense, one more attack. I think there's a lot more of these guys. I don't know what this one stands for. Oh, there we go. Armor. So they have a lot more armor as well. Movement. And then same morale. Okay, these guys have a little bit less morale as well. But I guess they are cheaper. They cost me... These guys are actually free as well. Which is kind of a bit crazy. So we're definitely going to pick up another one of them. And then we'll pick up one of these guys just because I want to see what they look like. So I'm going to stick them actually out of the city. Oh, I did not mean to get 2. Maybe I'll just get 1. Because I want to see what they look like. Yeah, there's a lot more of them. There's so many more of them. They're still very lightly armored. And I think they have axes. Yeah, they have axes as well. So yeah, as I said, they're a lot more lightly armored. But there's a lot more of them, I guess, to pile into combat. So that makes a lot of sense. So this army's going to be pretty good. I'm going to get rid of this militia as well. I just don't feel like we need it. Is there an easy way just to get rid of these guys? I think it's that, right? Yeah, cool. So let's get rid of them. And then, because I want to build some pike militia as well to go in this army. I want to get these pikes, which we'll do later on the time. Because we don't want to, like, kind of absorb our economy doing upkeep whilst we don't need to. Oh, yeah. Also, I'm not sure if I mentioned it. We actually upgraded this to a secondary city as well. So this is now the next level of the city. What that does is it increases the border of the city. Everything goes out an extra tile, which is cool. And it also allows you to, you know, build new buildings, have a lot more population. I think we can have up to 140 people now. So an extra 100 people on top of that, which is, again, really, really crazy. But also very cool. Are we building a road up here as well? Which we could definitely do. I don't think that city is. And this city is not either. So does anywhere actually have... Yeah, this place actually does have an unused population. So what we'll do is... Is it not going to let me? I guess not. Yeah, this one will, but it won't let me go off in that direction. So I guess this one will just have to, you know, slow up on a bit of growth. It can. This city can also upgrade as well. We're going to hold off on upgrading this city, I think, right now. And then just start building our roads, which take forever for whatever reason in this city. I guess... Oh, yeah, because they're already building roads down here, right, aren't they? Yeah. And then they'll make their way up here, slowly but surely. Because we want to link up with this city, it will allow our troops to traverse the territory a lot quicker. I feel like traverse, I'm sorry if you get annoyed by me saying it so much, but I feel like I say traverse a lot and it's like the word of this series, which I just keep on saying. Nice to see our troops going into the garrison as well. This general's just taking a while to actually get back to base camp, but as soon as he gets on the road, it should be much quicker. Much quicker. A couple more turns until this is all met up. These guys are just scouting around. I don't really know why these guys are going around this terrain. Like, we've already seen what's all over here. Maybe just taking control of these guys. There's a unit there, I guess. I guess there must be, like, a unit up here or something. Maybe even another faction. Maybe there is a faction, like, kind of off here. Because the map does almost end. Map ends, like, here, so... a disease over here that doesn't affect us whatsoever. I also thought, news of peace. Beast factions made peace. I thought it'd also be interesting if we actually look at the graphics as well, just to see how we're doing. You know, it's turn 59. If we just go ahead and jump into the ledger, and we can see who's winning. So at the moment, victory points is this faction, the two-star faction. We are third place. But I don't think victory points really matter so much. Cultural points, we're really far behind everyone. We're not really far behind, but we're like almost double behind. Number of cities, we are joint top with, you know, quite a few other people. Own population, we do actually have the most population in our cities, which is good. And I think I'm going to be building another city very, very soon, which again will just help boost ourselves there. Military strength, we're, you know, probably about half the strength of like a normal military strength of city, like the biggest one. And we're underneath the bar people who we're going to be going to war with. But again, as soon as my general gets back, I'm going to be amassing probably like 2 full stacks to go to war with, if not more. Battles fought, we haven't really fought any battles. Enemies killed. Anyone's killed any civilians yet anyway. Enemy soldiers killed. Damn, Bar have done good at defending. They've killed loads. And construction development, we are, you know, almost up there, but we're still a little bit further behind. So cool, that's nice. And that's just the people we've kind of encountered. So someone else could be really, really, really far ahead, and we would just have no idea. I don't think that's the case, but like I still feel like, because we're only playing on normal as well, you got to remember. So I don't think the AI is going to be completely shit stomping us. You know, it's going to be quite an easy pass. So we got a high tin bronze, lovely. That's exactly what I wanted. Getting this as well is so good. 7 more turns on that. So can we not complete 3 items to unlock? So do we have this unlocked or not? I guess not. Maybe it's 3 more items? But we don't have 3 more items. Or maybe we have to unlock everything, right? Because that's complete 24. Oh, we can get... No, we can't, right? Yeah, we can't. So I think you have to get literally everything in this tree before you can move on. So we need to get this in 4, like, ASAP. Which is all the way down here, damn. That's going to slow us up in this tech really, really badly. Let's get the silk weavers. And then in knowledge. Again, is there anything else we really need? Because this says complete 3 items to unlock. So I'm kind of confused how that works. Like, because surely we've unlocked this. Surely we've unlocked... I guess because we've only unlocked... I think how it could work is you have to unlock 3 of these before you can move on to the next tree. So because we've only got this tech right here, and we've only got this tech right here, so we haven't got this one, but we have also got this one. I wonder how that works. So maybe in this beta you can only get down to here and it stops. I'm not too sure. I'm gonna have to research that after we've done this playthrough, or after I've done this episode. Sorry. So now we've done this, I think we go down this, or do we get more sickness reduction? Increased culture, we don't really need. Could get some like horse archers and stuff like that. Heavy horse archers it would allow us to recruit. So maybe getting some of this. It also gives us noble archers, so it allows us to get more archers into our army. Because at the moment, I don't think we have any. Which is a bit bad. I think the next bit of territory I'm going to take is these rhinos down here. Just because it's an extra 60 gold straight away. Just for being there. I think everyone's still making food. Yeah, everyone is. Which is perfect. General is slowly making his way home. Soon to be here. Because, yeah, look how much further we can move on this road. So much further. So now he's here, he can literally just bomb it home and get back really, really quickly. And we're going to let our economy, which is really taking a pounding right now because of these troops. You know, we have not got cheap troops right now. What is this star faction going to do? If they raid my city up to the north, I'm going to be pissed at them. They better not. No, sorry. Sorry, Bar. We're going to go to war very soon. We have to stay enemies for a little bit longer, or quite a lot longer, until you're destroyed. Even though they are one of the more powerful factions in the game, which I've come across right now. So that's at least interesting. We have a lot of trade going through these cities. Yeah, maybe having another city a bit closer just to allow these two cities to trade would be a good idea. Because I think I do get quite a bit of money from trading. Yeah, look, we're already making, you know, 80 gold from both our trades. So maybe sticking a city in the middle, even though we're not next to the game or we're not next to the rhinos, maybe just sticking a city like right here to allow these two cities to trade and this city to trade with that. will just be really good for our actual empire, because I think it's within 12 tiles I think they can trade. So if we, what is it, like Alt B, no, Alt F, G, D, one of these buttons. Yeah, there you go, Alt G. So if we stick a city here, we'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, so we'll do that for sure. So let's build a citizen. We don't have enough money. It's 500 gold, wow. And our economy is not great. And I really want to save all that money as well for when we get our next market and stuff like that, because I really want to use that. Well, that's kind of weird, but we've just absorbed a bit of territory all the way over here. There we go. It just loaded up a bit. So yeah, you can definitely see the territory just expanding from this city for sure. Yeah, it's just like kind of expanding very slowly, but you know, pretty decently. Has anyone else upgraded their cities yet as well? None of these guys have. These guys have upgraded one. No one else really has, which is surprising that we're actually far ahead on that. These guys can keep on crossing the river. These guys are just exploring the mountains down to the south. Oh, there's some more copper down there as well. We haven't even got access to any of the copper. Get these temples to make the peasants happy or the nobles. How close are we done to the power? Yet 5 more turns. Cool. I mean, really all we're doing is just moving our army down, and then we want to go raiding all of their farmland, because that's another way to make a lot of money. From what I was reading and looking up, people were telling me that, you know, raiding farmland gives you a ton of money in the early game. So doing that with my army will be a good idea. It'll piss these guys off. It won't mean we're actually at war. They can fight me in their territory, but that's about it. And again, just go into the city. Then after that, we will build all our troops and then send them out on the move. And then we'll just send a full stack out to start raiding and stuff. I don't think they have too many troops around here. They have kind of a small army over here, but everything else is really in the city. There's lots and lots of farmland, like a lot of farmland here to raid. We'll start putting this army to good use. So at the moment, we have 5 units, so I think we can get another 4 maybe. I mean, we'll see when we actually go to the recruitment tab how many more we can actually get, right? Because I think it's this, right? So it's 368. Yeah, so you can get 8 units to an army. We can recruit a bunch as well. So we've got kind of a decent elite line. If we can just get some crappy... We don't have any... Yeah, that's a problem. We don't really have any missile, like, contingent here. It's not like letting me get any extra of these pikemen as well. Oh, there we go. Cool, it did it. So now we have 3 crappy units on the front. We have the elite infantry at the back, 3 nobles, noble axemen, and a trained axeman, and my general as well. So what we will do is we'll move this army down here. Then we will chain for formation as they get down here, because I'll mess around with a formation when we can actually see what they look like. And we can really go a bit more in depth in that, I think, and I think that'll be good. And then we'll go raiding. Cool. I think that'll be a good kind of thing to this episode. And we can really start getting into the combat and stuff like that. Yeah, look at our army on the map. So, like, from all the screenshots I've seen and stuff like that, I think it's very common, you know, obviously, as the game goes on, to have several... we have a new general as well. Perfect. We can use this general to have another army. We have 3 crappy units up here we can actually send. Actually, I kind of like leaving them up here to keep this province safe, actually. Even though, you know, they're expensive and stuff. We do have a new general. Huzzah. He's not that great, but, you know, he can kind of be happy and just chill here whilst we're trying to afford a new army, which is super expensive. So, cool. So, this is our army right now. I'm going to change this formation up to have a lot, not have this formation, because I want to make sure that we have thicker lines, like 3 lines. How do I do that? How do I create a new line? I know there is a way. I want to have, like, 3 lines. I know there's a way to do it. I know. I can't remember how I did it last time, though. Like this? No. Oh, my God. How did I do it? I had 3 lines. Maybe it's something like this. We go into a... I'm such an idiot. There you go. It says 4 lines, 3 lines, 2 lines, 1 line. Even though that's not even one line. Single line. That's not a very good single line. It's a very good formation for kind of just absorbing charges if you have like an entire line of elite infantry. But you want to go to 3 lines. I want to have pikemen on the front. This does mean that our flanks are probably a bit more vulnerable, but that's absolutely fine. So we'll have the front line of peasant pikemen. These guys will absorb the charges and kind of die. Then behind that, we'll have our noble axes ready to get in. Then behind that, we'll have our general, so he's nice and safe at the back. And then we'll have our trained axemen ready to die for him if it comes to that. If for whatever reason we manage to get cut down and everyone beats us. So we'll stick these pikemen in defense. No, these pikemen should be on attack, or should we try and absorb charges with them? Let's stick these guys. Let's see what they do actually. So charge, attack immediately, preferring melee attack from missiles. Defense, make a controlled attack using melee or missile as approaching if necessary. Outflank, walk around the enemy flanks before attacking. Harass, attack the enemy with missile fire. So this is more like a skirmish phase. Ambush, remain hidden until a suitable opportunity arises. Defend, hold position and wait for the enemy to approach. Reserve, hold back but attack enemy units threatening friends, and then withdraw. So I think maybe we just go in a more defensive army and let them attack us, even though we don't really have any missiles. So maybe charging would be a good idea. Sticking on these guys in reserve. So, oh no, these guys on our flank, or at least the two flanks. So these guys on our flank. So these guys are on our flank. This guy, I want to be on more defensive or reserve. Yeah, this unit will be on reserve, and then these guys will also be on reserve. Cool. So when we go into combat, hopefully these units kind of act good. These like axemen will go around the sides. Our pikemen will hold them into center. This central unit right here will hold the line as best as it can. You know, if it needs to go into combat, it will. And then same with my general and my trained axemen. Awesome. So let's go across the river and get ready to start raiding all of their lands. And I don't think they really expect it as well. Perfect. So we have actually stopped building food in all these provinces as well, so let's just quickly upgrade that. I could set this to automated, but I feel like it's, you know, it's fun doing this as well. You know, it gives me something to do. If I just set it to automated, I think I feel like it'd be kind of a bit boring. Let's keep just setting all this farmlands. We've kind of got all this central farmland done now, and we're just doing these outer farmlands. This city down here has grown really quickly as well. It's already up to 32 people. Which is not bad. We're about to finish up all the farmland here as well. So once this city, you know, it's going to be a small city, but I want to build walls there and just have a really like kind of sick opportunity. Our roads are being built up here as well. You can see our roads slowly getting built up here. Will eventually be what eventually yeah, will eventually get up there. I mean, our entire empire will be connected. I think they will add in bridges at some point as well, because at the moment you don't really have bridges, and I think we lose our speed bonus going across it still. Oh, no, that's not actually bad, I don't think, because, yeah, oh. Yeah, you actually get to move an extra no, you don't. Yeah, so it doesn't really matter. Okay, cool. We've got a secondary general here if we need to. We're going to let our economy build up a bit, because I want to save up as much money, because I want to get this market as soon as possible. Or at least see what the market does, because, again, it doesn't tell me what a market does, so I have no idea if it's good or bad. But we will find out. But our army does march off to war. Pikemen in the front, nobles in the second line, general in the back. I wonder if we can actually have four. Yeah, you can actually have four in this line. Oh, very interesting. I just have my general in reserve all the way back. So I could technically, yeah, have these two units right there in reserve and then have them on the flank and him in reserve as well. Nice. We're actually going to do that. I kind of like having my general all the way at the back and having a bit thicker lines with these guys outflanking. It also, I guess, will play into some strategy as well. Yeah, let's move up there and just start raiding. I'm not sure if they raid both the provinces or just one. Again, we can find out here. Fire over here as well, which will reduce the population. National myth is done, so what we want to do is start working down towards this one. So to have that, we need this and this. So we need to get this first. Or do we just get this? I'm so confused. Again, why can't we get any of this? I'm not sure if this is something I need to do, because we're about to have everything in this top tree. I guess I'm going to have to ask, like, Havoc or someone, because he knows a lot. Yeah, he knows, like, kind of what... Oh, no, cool. Complete one item to unlock this. So, yeah, we do just have to get everything prerequisite to it, I guess. Unlock one to unlock these. So, I guess it's different for each tree. Unlock one. Or maybe it's the same for everything. Okay, so yeah, it's the same for everything. You just need to complete a certain amount of tech. It can be down one tree, but then you need to, like, yeah, that's cool. I like how it does that. So you can kind of fall behind in some techs, but get really far advanced. Because right here, we've done everything. I'm probably not going to complete this as well. I'm going to wait a little bit and then jump onto something else. We've got 700 gold. Keep on saving up. Silk Weaver would be nice. It would produce a silk to trade, but we're not going to bother. Cool, I'm really starting to, you know, understand the game a bit better now. Oh, we'll watch our army go raiding. We'll slow it down a bit as well. Our pikemen are marching. On to glory, boys. So, I'm not sure if they raid both of them or just the province they're standing in. We'll find out. So, it's just the province they're standing in they raid. And how much? We got 50 gold from just looting one province. That is not bad. So let's just go on a looting spree, I guess. Nice. Our market is done. We also got another building as well. I think issue an edict to unlock. Cool. We'll do that. I think we'll start working on these irrigation farms. So we'll do well field systems. And then we'll think about what edicts. Because I haven't really popped a single edict. We actually have quite a few as well. Entering Roaring States. Oh, we actually have to issue this. It costs us 1,000 gold. Again, I kind of like that. Relocate nobles. Did we not just get one to do a farm? Like a tax or something, like a salt tax. I thought that's what we got from this. Yeah, enables edicts. Salt tax. Maybe we'll get it next turn. Yeah, this is the same for everything. Yeah, you just have to issue it. Oh, cool. That's interesting. I like how they've done that, actually. I guess this will be the one we'll do it. Makes the nobles a bit more pissed, but allows us to change unit availability. Yeah, that's cool. All grand command, but we don't really need that right now. So we'll pop this and make the nobles a bit pissed. Oh yeah, we don't even have to pop this. We just have to pop this. So we just need to save up some gold. But I want to build them buildings first before we go into the next stage. I'm not in a huge rush to go into the next stage. And we'll see what these buildings actually do. A market. Enables overland trade within 18 hexes. Trade value multiplier by 3. Costs us 80 gold to upkeep. Costs us 1,000 gold to build. And this. No goods available for re-export. Nowhere near to export. Allows important trade items to be exported. Okay, so if we have like gold here, maybe we can sell them there. We also have access to a stable. Give us train chariots. So we probably do want to pick that up at some point. But we need both these buildings to do that. And look how expensive they are again. I guess as the game goes on, you get a ton more money. Like, that's the only thing I can think of. Because at the moment, we are flat broke. But 18 hexes, will that put us in range of these two cities? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yeah, it would. And this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So yeah, getting a market here would be amazing. It means I wouldn't have to put another city here. And it would give us a load of trade. And it also could mean if we get a market all the way up here, it would allow us to trade with all of these cities as well. At least maybe somewhat, like maybe a few of these cities we could trade with, which is really, really good. We're going to continue looting that because the money it gives us is perfect and I don't want to give that up. We can build some more farms here quickly. Yeah, because our income is starting to move up. I think you just need to kind of get to a point, we can't actually build any more farms here. We do need to upgrade the city again. There's just so many buildings, you know, and I just don't have the money to do it right now. Again, carry on looting, carry on making tons of money. You know, this is something I should have probably been doing from the start, just with crappy units. Because I don't think anyone's really coming to stop me right now. Oh, we're looting everything around it by the looks of it. 100 gold from pillaging. So if we move close to the city, do we get attacked, maybe? I wonder if we go close to the city, if they like assault us or anything. There's actually a small army over here as well. There's like a general right here. I'm just looking, they don't have any troops anywhere. So let's move closer to the city. I just want to see if like the arrow towers like actually shoot us if we're close to the city or something like that. We also got the composite bows. Lovely. I'm gonna go ahead and get astronomy. Just because I don't know what this effect does and I imagine it's bad. So we're just going to avoid it at all costs. We can now build that market in our capital. Which we will do immediately. No, Silk Weaver. Oh my god, look how much expensive it is as well. Yeah, so we'll get the market immediately. I think this is an upgrade. Yeah, this is an upgrade because it's red. I think all the red ones are upgrades. Or like the next stage of the city. Because yeah, look, it's a red city. So I think it like goes green, red, and then blue. Because that looks blue. I think that's how it works. More farms here. This place just can't build any farms. So we need, again, we need to probably save up now after our market's built here to upgrade this city. Because at the moment, I imagine they're suffering from overcrowding pretty badly if we have a look. Yeah, overcrowding. This modifier has gone down from like almost one. So that's pretty bad. We are making decent money from looting though. Definitely something I'll probably, you know, when I start the next game, I'll be looting a lot more, a lot quicker. Are they going to come out and meet me or not? And do I suffer any attrition? I don't. I think because we're not at war, they can attack me, but they're just not right now. Again, looting more provinces. A fire has been caused in this city. That's good. I mean, the more fire, the better. And their army's all the way over here still. 150 gold from looting. Damn. Looting is so good. Maybe if I would have had looting earlier, I could have afforded a lot more men. Our new general here as well. We can't really afford anything else. Which is a shame. Do we try and take the city with these troops? Like, I feel like it's just not going to work. I think we just, like, carry on looting. Yeah, I feel like we just carry on looting. Maybe go to this city and start looting. Because I just don't know how strong these walls are. I guess we should try. Right? What does that mean? What does this two arrows mean? Again, I wish there was more tooltips in this game. I guess we will try before this episode ends to assault it. Maybe, like, right towards the end. Because it's already been a 30-minute episode. I kind of want to leave it. Oh, they're going to actually try and assault us or anything. I guess because we're not immediately fighting, but they are pouring in troops after troops, though. Lots of actual noble axemen as well. Or maybe these are general units. No, these just look like noble axemen. Fire over there. We don't really care about them. Again, 150 gold. Money in the bank right now. Yeah, you can see there. Their garrisons are definitely up, like rising up. I think maybe we march over here to loot these lands and just assault the city, even though the city has upgraded or has it not? No, it's still, yeah, still level one. Our walls over here have been built. And we have to obviously declare war on them as well, which is obviously something I have not done yet. Could get a granary. There's nothing really I want to pick up quite yet in any of these cities. What do we need to upgrade the walls as well? Because upgrading the walls obviously is going to be a vital part. It's just 2k. Cool. Yeah, we definitely want to... Yeah, we have 500 gold. Should we get another city going? These will allow us to trade with these guys. Maybe a city down to the south. But again, we are going to absorb these cities as well in our empire. We do want to get our hands on the copper. Is there no more farming? Wow, there's no more farming anywhere. That's pretty bad. So they're stuck at this food right now. I guess I'll stick some of the population on making the roads. They can't even make the roads as well. At least this way. No, they can't even make it down here with roads. That's pretty sad. We need to just get better technology for that to be a thing. But look how much stuff we can build in these mountains. It's so good. You know, copper mine and a gold mine. How much does the copper mine give us out of interest? 20 gold and produces copper to trade. I think, you know, it's kind of deceptive because, you know, it produces copper to trade as well as the extra income. This just gives us gold, but a copper we can trade, which I think will rack up a lot of money. Again, because we have that extra 15%. How's our army doing? How is our army doing? Just moving. Yeah, that's what we wanted. We still have this troops there. So if they try and make a move towards this city, we will stop them with our secondary general. More troops moving. Yeah, we're just kind of keeping out their way. Look at how much we pillaged. That is brutal. You can literally devastate a city. I think this is something you do. Yeah, of course they want this, but they're still offering us a crap amount of money. Yeah, I think this would be a really good way to starve out a city as well, which is interesting. I guess this means, oh no, this is one of my city, isn't it? Damn. Yeah, in our capital as well. What does that do? Just unrest. Unrest is really bad because if it rises up, they actually form up an army. Which is really bad. And this city's not as bad. But so, like, how do I get this under control? I guess I just build more troops. I have to build more troops. So let's amass some cheap-ass pikemen. I think I just have to click it and redo it. Yeah, some pikemen and some of these guys who are a bit cheaper. And a unit of nobles. This will obviously help us. Yeah, it reduces the suppression by some... I think we get a bunch more suppression. Because, I mean, we do have almost a full stack here. I want to stick all my crappy pikes in the front. No, we actually have to have a four line. Yeah, let's change this to three line again. I just feel like three line is just really, really good. I'm hoping that will make the city a bit happier. This one's starting to starve as well because it can't afford it out. So yeah, as I was saying, like, I feel like looting all this land will devastate the food population here. So like having this extra stored food is just really important. You know, having these granaries and stuff like that just really, really does pay dividends. Like really, really does pay off in the long run. So again, yeah, we're making our way down here. I think before we go into this territory, I will declare war on them. Yeah, so this turn we'll declare war on them. We'll march through the mountain pass. Again, this is a really good defensible city. There's like one way in. We have to go through the mountains. Yeah, of course, we'll be friendly. I think these guys have the biggest military. Again, we can actually see who has the biggest military right now. We do, and they are a close second. So that's a bit scary that we're fighting the next powerful person we've met. The two-star people, their military has gone down massively. Considering they fought the most battles, so I guess they're losing against someone. Who are they even at war with? No one right now. They've made peace with whoever they were originally fighting. Our craft has been done. So we do need to pop that edict. Oh my god, we're out of money as well, I guess, because of all the extra troops we have risen. But it's kind of a necessity just to lower the unhappiness of these two cities, because if they rebel, I lose the entire city. Oh my god, why? Food shortages. Because of a locust. Oh, damn. I guess we'll get to see what rebellion's like as well. Because I know his entire city just goes. Like, it just goes like that. Again, the peasants are uprising. There's nothing we can really do about it right now. Because it's not the nobles which are the issue. I can pop edicts to get the nobles happier. But I can't pop edicts to make the peasants happier. I don't have any mountains or anything to change it. So, yeah, I guess we're just going to have to kind of almost take the hit. Which wasn't really, you know, it's not really our fault that we've got this. It's just, you know, some random event that happened, which is kind of annoying. Our economy is so painful as well. But I kind of need this secondary army. Has a market built yet? The market's going to build next turn, which I'm somewhat happy with. Yeah, let's go to war. You know, the best thing is we go to war. They have no allies or anything. Could I get these guys as, like, a friend? Or can we not? I don't think we can actually we can't actually make a friend agreement, like an alliance, until we actually finish our original agreement. So let's declare war. We can propose to declare war. That seems a bit silly. Let us hope you have the stomach for what you have started. Yeah, me too. I feel like we're going to get slaughtered. So how do we initiate a siege? Just like that. And then we'll storm the city, hopefully looting everything around. So we've kind of got our army set up. We're going to be marching through. Oh, they've got an army reinforcing, or at least coming, to try and stop us. Our army is marching through the mountains. And here we go. We outnumber them massively. They've only got some basic militia spearmen. But again, you can actually see, like, because this is such a small pass, it's kind of hard. My men are having to go one by one into this combat. And we obviously won the day. So now what happens? Do we just lay siege to the city? Or can we not even get through the walls or something? That's what I'm interested in. Oh, these guys are coming in as well. So how does this work? We obviously were victorious. We lost like 20 men. They lost 66. They lost the entire unit. Wow, that's brutal. Our market is done here. Does that mean we are now trading with our entire empire? We're trading with this one, but not this one. I guess it's just not as long. Our economy, though, is painful. The unrest is still an issue in both of these cities. I'm going to have to get rid of some of these troops. I just can't upkeep them right now. Yeah, there's just nothing I can do about these troops. Oh, yeah, I have to get a garrison. Right, I can get rid of these train dudes. I kind of wasted a 300 gold building these guys. But we're going to have to kind of do it to help our economy out. See what our economy is next turn. Yeah, take the city, boys. We're a bit depleted. They obviously have reinforcements coming in the back. Well, at least they had reinforcements coming in the back. Not sure where they've gone now. Or can we not even take the cities because we don't have... Maybe we can't even take the cities because we can't... We literally have nothing to break down the walls with. I think maybe that's the case. If that is the case, we will just start sieging. See, maybe we need siege equipment. Oh, no, we don't want to declare war on them. So, yeah, just, like, Just siege. I mean, just like burn everything. They have got their army coming as well. We just ignore that. Just keep on burning. Yeah, maybe we can't actually take a city because we can't break down the walls, which would make sense, you know. Our men will just run up these walls and then get repelled back. Like, they can't climb over them. We will have siege equipment very, very soon. Very soon, because, you know, as soon as we pass the edict, when we actually have enough money. Income reduced because of peasants being unhappy. But the peasantry are starting to become happy. You know, they're starting to get refed. The farms are starting to be re-sown. Good, so we have declared war. That's good. We actually are at war. And they're bringing their army back as well. We should just be looting all of this. And if they want to fight us, they're more than welcome to. But I don't know. I don't know if I'm just doing something wrong. If there is actually a way we can do it. So they want to give us 430 gold for this. They obviously see my mighty military prowess. I kind of feel like the AI is a bit random. Like, sometimes they give you loads of money, sometimes they give you nothing. I think it's to do with how strong your military is. And these guys are like, shit, this guy is like aggressive, he's going to war. I want to make peace with him, so have a bunch of money. And especially could we just loot, look, how much money did we just get? 150 gold. Which means we can pop up into the next era, which we will do. I think going up in the next one, we're pretty much there on this one. We're on there with this one. We're pretty much on here with this one. Knowledge is getting there. Maybe we wait a little bit. Maybe we just wait a little bit and build some more buildings. Like, maybe another building somewhere. Maybe like another market. I mean, a market here wouldn't be good. Anything else here? Silver weaver. Again, look how much money it costs. It must be able to, like, it must pay dividends. Somehow. Armory. No archers and trained. So we need to get this as well on top of. Yeah, I guess we just go up because we're kind of wasting technology in our craft, which is our main bit of tech. So we enter this. Noble rest for 10 turns. Enables technology in units. This edict may not be cancelled. Yeah, it just costs us 1,000 gold. Nobles will be a bit pissed, but noble isn't our issue. It's the peasants, which we're issuing right now. Boom. So we should. Yes, now we can go down here. So we can actually get artillery camps straight away. Oh, cool. So it enables you to construct artillery camps. Is that just for building? Spears and crossbows. So we want to get them. Better walls. Shooting galleries. I guess that's when the towers start shooting enemies that are near. Cool. So we're actually getting into some interesting technologies now. We do need to get better chariots as well. We do need to get down that tree. I want to get down here when we have like the beehive rocket artillery. And cannons and stuff down here. And this, the 100 Tiger rocket launcher, just seems amazing. Thunderclap bombs, like some of the stuff down here just seems brutal. So we'll wait for this to be done, and then maybe we'll get this, and then maybe we'll start working down there. But it's mainly to do with our crafts, you know. We want to push it down here as fast as possible. Armor works, copper mines, deep copper mines, deep gold mines, deep jade mines. Increase valuable of silver trade. I don't think we have too much of this right now. So let's get the better mines. Not that we have any mines right now, but we'll just pop it anyway. So again, the nobles are going to be a bit pissed next turn, but the nobles are fine. We do want to build another city as well. Oh, farming's just such an issue in this city. It really is. I guess we want to try and build like these copper mines as soon as possible. 800 gold. Okay, cool. That's what we're going to save for then. Maybe having a granary here would be good because it stores food. I think we'll just carry on looting. Maybe move on to this city next. With our army. I mean, our army's doing a good... Oh, we're actually going to fight us. Cool. Bring it on. Oh, maybe we're just engaging them. We've got some units in reserve. Our front line is moving out. Pikemen are going to crash in. These guys are pretty good, so they're probably going to cut through. Oh, I saw some arrow fire as well going into these guys. Yeah, I actually saw some arrow fire moving over from the city. So the city is actually helping. I think we just won, though. We are losing men. So that's a bit of an issue. Maybe we'll have to loot, like, raid the city and then loot back round to replenish. It's snow time as well, so I wonder how that affects our men. We are all experienced, though. Our general is very good in combat. We got another 50 gold from looting. That's done. I want to get these irrigation farms. Crops need water to grow and supply from the river can help create more. Oil from the river holes. All year round. So yeah, I don't think you actually make food in the winter or something, because that's what this kind of technology suggests, right? That you don't actually do that in the winter. Getting this would be nice as well, but I just need these. I need this technology so badly. But then actually being able to siege a place would be better. So let's just get the artillery. I think actually being able to siege it, and that's what you guys want to see more, is the actual sieges and stuff like that. So let's just pick that up. We can actually work down to the crossbow as well, and I get cavalry crossbowmen straight away. That would be brutal. That would be absolutely brutal. I want to get chariots as well in my secondary army. That's more of like a hit and run army. Again, there's just no food for these provinces. This province needs to be upgraded. These are fine right now. This is not fine. Everywhere else is okay. Yeah, they still have plenty of places to get more food, which they will do. And the trade's going to be helping out. It's such a shame that these cities aren't trading. Maybe building a market like in this one, because that must be in range. Must be. That kind of feels like a waste. But again, he might also be in range of like the cities up here as well. There's just so much to think about. Like, because... No, that's no way that's enough. But maybe here is close enough. Maybe. Don't think it will be. And we obviously also lost some money from no longer trading with these guys. We're going to continue just burning all of this land. See if we can take this city. I don't really know how it works too much. Maybe we just need artillery to actually take the cities. Because I think I did see something about Havoc when he was playing. Like, he's like, oh, I've got artillery now. Let's go take some cities. So I'm not sure if that was just a statement like you need it to take walled cities. Which is kind of a cool way. I kind of like that because it means you can't just like just shit stomp someone so early on in the early game. All right, let's make our way onto this. It does say it's one turn left, but I think we did just get that. So let's do that. Flaming rocks and flaming arrows. I mean, that's interesting. I think I'd rather the disease outbreak, if I am honest. An extra 50 gold from looting. Okay, guys, damn, this has been a 46-minute episode. I did not mean it to be this long. I was just really, really into the game and just playing a bunch. So next episode, what we're going to do is we're going to send this secondary army we have. This has actually changed color as well as we've gone up in age. This army is going to move into here and start looting anything else that still remains. This army is going to be moving down because these cities must be suffering because we've just been killing all their farmland. Especially these guys as well. They're definitely taking advantage. Yeah, we are just looting and pillaging all this farmland. So they their cities must be suffering, whereas ours is you know almost untouched. Look how vibrant my empire is. You know, so many people everywhere. Even coming across here, you know, it'd be amazing we have all of this done as well. I think building a second city here, which I'm gonna just do now. We're gonna do it in this city because I need to reduce the population in this city anyway, because I still need to upgrade it. Again, we don't have enough money. So yeah, when we do, we'll build it here because it reduces the population and we need that to happen here. Yeah, I can upgrade three of my cities right now. So we need 3,000 gold. We need to find a better way to make money on this game. We really do. Again, I think one of the reasons we're so broke is because imagine if we were like here. We'd be trading with like every single faction. But the fact that we're just off in a corner means we just don't get to trade with as many people as you would normally. But obviously we have the extra protection from being off by ourselves. So it's kind of like a kind of a give and take there. Okay, cool. So I'm going to end the episode here. If you enjoyed this, make sure to drop a like. Make sure to drop a comment. It really helps out the channel. And I'll see you guys next time. And fish out.